I was hoping you weren't waving at me.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Joust, a mighty medieval musical. My name is Stephanie Sullivan, and I'm the assistant principal here at SES. I am very proud to announce all the students and staff and all their hard work that they've been working over the past couple of months for Joust. Go on back it up. While they're backing it up, a couple quick announcements. If there's an emergency, please follow the exits around the side of the building. Also, take a moment to silence your cell phones. At the end of the performance, there'll be a photo opportunity where you can come up and take pictures of each of the cast members. I do want to take a couple minutes to just thank some very important members, because without you, this wouldn't have happened. Mrs. McCrory, Mrs. Skoronsky, Mrs. Hannon, and two very important students, Evelyn Finley and Annabelle Hamilton. And last but not least, please stand, Mrs. Benstead. Thank you for putting your heart and soul into this musical, because without you, none of this would have happened. So thank you, and enjoy the show.
Yet mighty medieval men!
Let me tell you.
Oh, Marlena, let us tell you. You'll go on for days.
Well, I guess that'd be all right. But
it was the day of the big joust. All the knights were in the roped-off area with their armor, horses, weapons,
and attended by the young squires.
Squires are young men who hope one day to be knights themselves.
The squires do everything for the knights, including getting them ready for the joust.
Remember, Arthur was the squire for Sir Hector.
Everybody's gathered for the biggest joust of the year.
It's like the World Series of all jousts.
The Stanley Cup!
The Super Bowl!
The Olympics of the jousting world!
Enough already!
Let's have a song!
She just said that.
It is in front of the sword stabbed stone that Squire Arthur finds himself on his way home to retrieve Sir Hector's sword.
But wait, you probably don't recall from that legend is just a few steps away from that stone was another stone.
And sticking out of that stone was something even more enchanting than the former king's sword.
And that's what caught Arthur's attention.
Two stones, each with something interesting protruding from it. I only have time to choose one and get back to the joust. Well, this one is most certainly a sword and seems the logical choice. But this one is much more colorful and seems full of many fantastic possibilities.
Thank you. Now it all seemed fine, till rumor has it there's an attack coming from France.
Your Majesty, rumor has it there's an attack coming from France.
She just said that.
An attack coming from France? Oh no!
We'll all surely go down in defeat.
But your Majesty, what are we to do?
We should sing a round. Rounds are good. Here, gather around my round table and I'll show you what I mean. We're the knights of the round table. We are strong and we are able. There's no foe we cannot vanquish. We know violence might. Sing with me! Received news
that there's an attack coming from France.
And we damsels are backing him up by not being nice to the men until they go along with the king. And that's the way it's gonna be.
Yes, I truly believe that if we always work for a land filled with harmony, we could put down our swords and shields forever and live side by side with our neighbors in friendship. And now I put my entire kingdom in jeopardy.
Think.
And then something very special began to happen.
Standing ovation, you earned it. Thank you, you're a wonderful audience. So we have a special award for this is the first time I ever had a student director, 34 years of teaching, 1990. Hi, former students.
First time I ever had a student who could do it. So Annabelle Hamilton, thank you for being my student director. This is the first time I've helped with choreography. My background is in cheer. So when Ms. Bunstead said that I would have a student helper, I was overjoyed. And Evelyn was above and beyond what I could hope for. She came to extra rehearsals that she didn't need to be at to help me teach the dance. She was extremely patient with her classmates and was always willing to take the time to do the steps slower. I really appreciate Evelyn. And we're going to let you come do pictures in a moment. I just want to remind everybody that the performers, there's pizza for you in the lobby. Only the performers, one piece. Thank you, Julie's Pizzeria and Mrs. Kibbercolor's mom. And if you didn't give your t-shirt order form yet for Chorus Band and Orchestra, it's due Thursday. Thank you. Get ready for pictures.